times I told you to stay away from here? I told you time and time again. Now I warned you.
Down and join us for breakfast. I smell Alice's biscuits. I heard Camille getting up about an hour ago. She must be starving by now. Look, I'll tell Alice that you're going to join us for breakfast, okay?
No, Daniel. Don't wait. Olivia
won't be coming down today.
Oh, more in a year like this, Mr. Stewart. She's got so thin, I can near see through her. Mm. Must be something a body can do. I can't hardly stand to see her suffer like that.
I'll get it.
Daniel.
Judge. Why don't you all come in?
Can't stay, Daniel. We're on our way to a funeral over at Collinsville.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all right. Mrs. Shelton's old uncle. Nobody could stand him. Looks like you don't have much of a green thumb, Daniel.
Oh, yeah, well, Camille and I, we'll do the best we can. Just in case Libby wants to, you know, take care of him again.
Mm-hmm. Well, Daniel, I have something to tell you.
Yeah.
Oscar Henley was shot last night.
Oscar? You mean little Oscar?
Yeah. He's still alive, but the doc says it might be better if...
What happened?
Ranch Shipley rigged some sort of shotgun trap to keep the deer out of his garden. Oscar slipped in over the fence and... Well, any fool could see a thing like that was dangerous. Anyway, Lansdowne is gonna file charges against Rance today. Attempted murder. And if that boy dies...
Rance couldn't hurt a fly.
Well, he made a mistake. The adults make them and the children pay the price. But you know that. Horace got the sheriff to put Rance in jail last night. Being a congressman, Horace does get what he wants. Hold your horses, Letitia. Nobody's gonna bury anybody till we get there. Look, I'm satisfied that whatever happened out there was not a criminal offense. A useless, stupid, avoidable accident. But still, just an accident. But this is an election year, and the prosecutor is not about to cross Horace. Rance needs a good lawyer. Defend Rance. He's your people. It might be your second chance, Daniel.
Oh, no, no, no. I can't take this case. You know that. I can't bring back those memories. Well, Oscar played on this very porch with my son. He sat in my lap like my own son when he got hurt. Please, Judge, all I want is peace. Please, just let me be.
Does Olivia get out at all anymore? I learned it myself, Daniel. If you want peace, you gotta fight for it. If you fight, you live. If you don't, you die.
Better than nothing.
Hey, is that the weekly there?
Yeah, I brought this for you. I thought you might want something to read.
Look at it. That's Sam Henley there. Look at that. That's Sam Henley. That's Horace's oldest boy. Uh-huh. Hey, went out and shot himself a wild turkey. Him just 14 years old. Oh, see, you know them wild turkeys so spooky you can't even blink.
I know that?
Yeah. He's got to sit there and think about being invisible. Oh, you got to just become a spirit right there. Oh, nobody can do that. No siree. Don't you know Horace is proud?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what the story says from hunting the guns and all. You gonna say that for him.
I'll see that he gets it.
Yeah. And you, miss, you done so much for me and my kids since Maddie died. You know, I seen you down at the Silver Shade, watching them string them electric wires. You know that is thanks to you. You know that is. You and Horace Henley. And Maddie, too. You know, God rest her soul.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Rance. It's okay. Yeah.
You know, the kids, they just hungry for meat, and I'm tired of the deer getting the garden before we do, so I just rigged me up a little. Just don't know how it could have happened. I don't know how. And I know Oscar ever since the boy was old enough to cross over and play with my children. You know, I wouldn't hurt the boy to save my life, and you know that. You
I know. That. I know.
You know that.
I'd like to stay here for a little while longer.
Well, you suit yourself.
Thank you.
But an ocean of tears won't wash the blood from those hands.
What am I going to do, Mr. Stewart?
Rance, we'll talk about that later.
Mm-hmm.
Rance, it's okay. It's okay. It's all right, man. Don't worry, Rance. It's going to be all right. We'll see what we can do, okay?
Paging Dr. Logan. Paging Dr. Logan.
Hey.
Horace.
It's mighty good of you to come back.
Horace.
Mighty good. You know Bill Lansdowne, of course.
Yeah.
Came by to discuss what charges we should file.
Daniel.
Bill.
Horace. How's your boy?
Oh, he's not good. He might never be good. Him, but 10 years old. Yeah. If he dies.
I know. I know how it is.
He's gonna pay!
Sit down.
What?
Hey, I think you ought to see a doc.
No, I'm fine. It's just these spells, you know.
No, I still think you ought to get looked at.
No.
Well, I've got some charges to file. Be in touch, Horace. Daniel?
Hey, Dr. Logan. You're not here to defend Rance on this, are you?
No, I can't go through with it.
You want to see Oscar?
Can I cheer him up if he recognizes you?
Alaska.
It's a long time since I saw you. You hang in there, son. You're tough. You're gonna make it.
I'm awful glad you came, Mr. Stewart. Oscar, mate, we've missed you.
I miss you too, Ruthie.
To climb out of poverty. But first, it starts with electricity. And a vote for Horace Henley is a vote for progress. A vote to put the kerosene lamps and torches out forever here in Silver Shade. Never again will a young mother like Maddie Shipley be burned to death by an exploding kerosene lamp. Never again you have to drive 5 miles for help. Help that comes too late. But folks, help is here. Help is now. Help is Horace Henley in Congress in 1958.
Thank you. Thank you.
Keep Horace Henley in Congress. Vote on August 2nd. Y'all come out.
Don't you let him fly free. Here's your father. Late as usual.
Daddy!
Hey, man. How you doing?
I caught 10 lightning bugs. I'm gonna make a little bracelet for Mama.
Oh, yeah? I bet your mama liked that, too, didn't she? Yeah? I better go in and see her. You go play. Go ahead.
Honey, that fat is ready to go.
Psst, come here. Got a kiss for an old soldier home from the wars. Lucky, I'm sorry. You know what kind of windbag Horace could be when he's in front of a crowd? That's just 30 miles of dirt road back from Silver Shade.
Hmm.
Honey, we have got to get Horace reelected. Do you know what it means to have a United States congressman owe me? It gives us opportunities we never would have otherwise. This house, for example. Camille's college.
At what price, Daniel? We never see you. And you knew it was Danny's birthday, and he has been waiting for you all evening to catch them lightning bugs.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm going to run right out. I'll get you 2 necklaces and a pair of earrings. How about that? Huh?
Don't try to kid me out of it. It's been like this ever since Maddie Shipley died in that fire. It's almost like we're not here.
But, you know, if there was electricity up in Silver Shade, Maddie Shipley wouldn't have a kerosene lamp to knock over.
Oh, and so you're the angel sent by God to bring the light to Silver Shade. Daniel, you're not that important. Nobody is.
Baby, people can be that important. But, I could concentrate on my excuses a little bit more if you could get them lethal weapons out your hands. Livy, look. If I can get Horace to string those lights in Silver Shade for those poor farmers, they'd have lights and phone. And no more Maddie Shipley's would have to die. Now, is it over? I have to pack my bags and hit the road. Don't let the screen door hit me on the way out.
That would be correct.
Yeah, correct this.
And this.
Oh, us. Oh, we got a porch full of company.
Yeah, I got a porch full of company. It's all I need right here. As long as I can dance with you.
Ew. You'd think they'd be old enough to stop that stuff.
Oh, never. How was Alice's chicken pot pie, Daddy?
That woman can no more make a pie crust than I can. But she's so clean, you could eat it off the floor. If you could eat it at all.
Why don't you just tell her you don't like it?
And hurt her feelings? No, I couldn't do that after all she's done for us. I'd much rather choke on that crust.
You are the best man I know.
Oh, really? Is that so? What's this? Huh? Why do you have to move so far away from home, baby girl?
Oh, St. Louis isn't so far. Paul's parents are there. And where else can we both get teaching jobs? How's Rance doing, Daddy?
Well, I've got another lawyer coming to see him on Thursday.
But you've always helped Rance. Mama would have said you should help him yourself.
Well, after what happened to Danny, things are different now.
I'm going on home. I got your supper in the oven, and there's a custard in the icebox.
Uh-huh.
How was that chicken pot pie?
Alice, words cannot describe it.
Mr. Stewart?
Hold on a minute. What is it, Alice?
Aurora asked me again today, can she come and talk to Mrs. Stewart?
What'd you tell her?
That it'd kill Mrs. Stewart just to lay eyes on her. That's what I always tell her.
Thank you, Alice.
But she always tells me she's got something important to say, and I tell her, I say, Aurora, I don't care if you are my sister. You leave Mrs. Stewart alone. Whatever it is, it's over now. Past is past. It won't change anything now. Well, y'all have a good night. Leave the dishes in the sink. I'll take care of them in the morning. Camille, you better get a move on. You'll miss choir practice.
Oh, maybe I shouldn't go tonight, Daddy.
Oh, that's all right, baby.
I don't want you to be lonely.
You stay right where you are. You just go ahead on, okay?
Good night, Olivia.
You come to see what happened?
No, I just brought you a few things. Some sugar, some flour, stuff like that. And there's a few candy bars in there for you know who. You kids doing all right?
Are they gonna split us up? Us kids, I mean.
Well, what makes you think a thing like that?
There was some government woman around here yesterday. Out of nowhere, she says they won't take all of us kids together. Two little kids started crying right then. Took me all day to calm them down. Haven't slept good since then. Every time a car drives by, I jump.
Don't you worry. I won't let that happen.
How's Dad doing?
Oh, he worried about y'all.
You tell him not to worry. We're fine. How long you figure it take for you to get him out?
Well, there's another lawyer coming to see him tomorrow.
Two lawyers? Lordy, thank you, Mr. Stewart. I knew it'd be okay as long as you were around. You know, Dad always said that about you ever since Mama died. Maybe you could bring us in to see him sometime.
Sure, son.
I knew we could depend on you.
What do you think?
I think time flies.
Nellie says it's held up real well. She says you can hardly tell it's 25 years old. Didn't turn yellow at all, did it, Nellie?
Last time somebody wore that dress, they were dancing. With me.
Daddy, Are you all right?
Do you think an old man can't waltz three turns without gasping for air? Come on.
Now, don't try to kid me out of it.
You not only look like your mother, but you sound like her. Now, you better go back there before that lady sticks pins in me for keeping you. Go ahead.
I love you.
I love you, too.
Box, in case you change your mind. I don't think Camille's gonna have any either, starving herself for the wedding, I guess.
Allison, I don't know what we would have done without you.
Oh,
if you had
after all you'd done and tried to do for my sister, my family would have done more if we could.
Thanks.
Good night now.
Good night.
Mr. Stewart.
Aurora. You shouldn't be here. What if Livy hears?
She can't see me out here. I have to talk to you. It's about Rance. The horse knows all about shitting accidents. What is and what ain't.
But what has that got to do with Rance?
I don't know. But what I do know is the truth ain't all out about what happened at Rance's. Horse is trying to use Rance. Just like he used me. And you. Will you help him?
Oh, no, I've had enough nightmares to last me a lifetime.
Has running from them made him go away? When I was young, I did a stupid secret thing that I didn't think would hurt anybody. And it caused so much suffering, I want to make up for it. This is my chance. See, but I'm nobody. I'm less than nobody. You know, I can't do a thing. There is something that can be done here. But it has to be you that does it. I know what Horace cost me. And I know you remember what it cost you.
Thank you.
I've decided to defend Rance.
Well. What's Horace gonna say when he hears this?
Don't care.
I ever tell you I was good at research?
Mm-mm.
There you were. Always a big supporter of Horace. And then your son dies. And you suddenly quit campaigning for Horace Henley. And now, lo and behold, miracle of miracles, almost overnight, they're putting electricity in Silver Shade. How about that? So what is it exactly that you have on Horace? Does it have any bearing on this case? Or on why you took it? Well, you know, someday, somewhere, somebody will tell. After all, we're all just a little corrupt, aren't we?
Are you sure this thing will even go off?
Oh, sure. I test fired it myself before I filed the charges. Can't be too careful in election year. Yeah, the recoil blew this thing clean off the fence. We found it in the sweet peas. These were in the chamber. Recently fired, of course.
How's Oscar?
He squeezed his mother's hand last night. Mm-hmm. The boy isn't gonna die.
Good.
And because of that, I'd be willing to discuss some reduced charge. We can make a deal that'll get Rance out in, say, 6 years with good behavior. 6 years isn't long.
Oh, no. Not long at all. Goes by in a heartbeat.
There you go. No time at all. And then you can put your energy into finding some kind of decent foster home for Rance's kids. Or find some long-lost relative wants to take care of them.
Of course. Kids.
Right. You talk to him, Daniel. Make him see reason.
Right.
My youngest, Charlie and Nancy, they were sick for 2 or 3 days, and I'd been up with them every night, and I was so tired. And I'm not sure, but I think this. One night, I never got out to load that gun, I think.
Rance, look, I'm glad that you didn't load the gun in the daytime, but if you can't do any better than that, I can't help you. You've got to remember.
I can't say for sure about anything anymore, Mr. Stewart. My mind is so twisted up. If I could just get that time back to me, just 1 minute, just bring that knife back to me.
No. You can't think about things that you cannot change. You go crazy.
6 years. I miss him so bad already. But don't bring him here to see me, Mr. Stewart. Don't let them see their papa in jail.
Rance, you're not going to spend 6 years away from anybody. Any time at all. I just wanted to let you know personally.
Even with everything that's happened, you never betrayed me before.
Am I betraying you now, Horace?
You forget where you came from. You're still just a skinny little poor kid in overalls to me.
You're still the son of the town drunk to me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I was all fine and dandy when the favors were being passed around, wasn't it, huh? Oh, but when the trouble comes, when the chips are down, it's no longer guilt or innocent. Hell no, it's black or white. It's yours or mine, huh? What better way for you to get back at me, right, Daniel?
Horace, you're forgetting the people who need you, and you use the people who helped you, including me.
You didn't use me? How many government contracts, how many favors did I give you? Can you even count them?
You remember what it cost me to get the last one? Danny died because of you. Horace, you've changed. I helped you because we're both poor and we wanted to make a difference. You could run for office. You could have the power, and I couldn't. But you have changed, Horace. You've gotten cold and you've gotten hard. I got you started. And I can bring you down.
Thank you.
Livy, I need to talk to you.
Come in.
I'm going to defend Rand Shipley.
And who makes this up to Oscar, Daniel? What defense could there possibly be for hurting a child? What if he dies?
Oscar's not going to die. I just thought I'd let you know.
You took this case because Aurora asked you to, didn't you? After what she did to this family.
Aurora has done nothing to this family.
She ripped its heart out. But you always had time for everybody else.
You know, it seems to me that you never have time for us anymore. Camille? For me?
Oh, that's not true, Daniel. See, I got nothing but time. An eternity that I would have gladly given to our son. Because I have no use for it now. This time so precious to you that you couldn't wait for me for 5 minutes that day. 5 minutes!
Oh, no. What is it tonight and how late are you going to be?
Aurora Watling and not very. Promised to meet her here at 5. Going to take her to get her children's things out while Barney's out. I'll be back for dinner.
Can't she do that herself?
Oh, no, 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 no. I beat her half to death the night she ran off. Plus, I don't want Horace distracted. He's got a big speech to me.
You mean Horace asked you to move his mistress's things out?
No, no. Aurora asked me. I am her divorce lawyer, you know. I don't want her to ask Horace anything. He doesn't even have to know.
Well, maybe he's got some boots you can lick, too, Daniel.
Olivia.
What?
Your cousins are still reading by a kerosene lamp. I'm this close to changing.
Okay, all right. You pick Danny up. I'll come home.
You'll be here by 5? Aurora! You're early. What's up, Danny? Come on in.
We got to go now.
Olivia will be back in a minute. We can go then. Come on in. Sit down. Dan, I bet you know where your mama hid those peanut butter cookies. I think Mrs. Watley might like one. Huh? Go ahead.
I should never marry Barney. I knew he drank. But one like me didn't have any choices. Look, Barney's shift gets off at 7, and I can't be there.
It'll be long gone before he gets home. Now you sit down. Try to relax. Sit down.
Well, I go there alone myself, but he beat me pretty bad the last time.
It's only soda pop. There's nothing else in there.
I'm sorry. You can't live with Marty for 5 years without checking. My 4-year-old knows the difference between vodka and gin. I'm sorry.
Aurora, does Barney own any guns?
Oh, no. Please, Mr. Stewart, we've got to go now.
Okay, Aurora. We'll go. Danny? We're gonna go for a ride. Now you can take that cookie with you, but you're gonna have to sit in the back seat and be quiet.
I'll be the invisible man.
All right. Come on, let's go.
All you have to do is wait. Little thing. Just wait. You knew he was dangerous. You knew he was violent. You still took him.
know what it feels like. Now, how easily I could have saved him. How easily I let him to his death. I don't think you have any idea, Olivia. I don't think you have any idea what it feels like to be responsible for something like that.
How would you know how I feel?
For a ride, but you're gonna have to sit in the back seat and be quiet. How about that?
I'll be the invisible man.
That's right. Let's go.
You may as well go on in there. I'll be outside the door. No, just go ahead on in there. Barney's not due back for another hour and a half. Danny, you sit back, boy. You stay in the car.
Why is that door open?
Danny, I told you. Oh, God.
Did you get them all, Garner? Did you check under the table?
We got them all, Letitia.
She broke 8 ribbons, Daniel. That means they're going to have 8 children. 8, did I tell you that?
Yes, Letitia, you told us that.
You must have invited every woman in town, Mrs. Shelton.
Well, let's see. There was the Ladies Voter League, the Church Women's Committee, Camille's friends from school, and then the rest were Olivia's old friends.
Thank you, Mrs. Shelton. Thank you for everything.
Yes, dear.
Judge, I'll see you in court on Monday.
You might want to reconsider the prosecutor's offer, Daniel. Horace is going to milk that jury for every drop of sympathy they got. Oscar may be able to testify. But I didn't tell you that.
This court is now in session.
Call your next witness.
May it please the court, the state calls Oscar Henley to the stand.
Oscar, do you promise to tell the whole truth so help you God?
I do.
Now, Oscar, I promise not to keep you up here too long, okay? How you feel today? Good. Now, I want you to speak up as loud as you can so that we can all hear you. And I want you to tell us, Oscar, what happened the night you were shot.
I waited for everybody to fall asleep. Because I wanted to go over to Mr. Shipley's garden.
And why'd you want to go there? Oscar, you don't have to be afraid.
I wanted to steal a watermelon.
Well, son, I think that's all right. I imagine there's one or two people here that might have done that themselves when they were your age. Then what happened?
I left our yard and got across the field. I walked up along the fence by the woods. Then I climbed the fence and that's the last thing I remember.
No more questions, Your Honor. Your witness, Mr. Stewart.
Hi, Oscar. You remember me?
You were Danny's father.
That's right.
Danny was my best friend.
Oh, yeah. You mind if I ask you a few questions? You feel up to it?
I'm okay.
Good, good. Let's see. Your father, he likes to hunt, doesn't he?
He can shoot the eye out of a squirrel from 100 yards.
Really? In fact, your big brother, he shot his first wild turkey this year, didn't he?
Yes, sir. Sam did.
Yeah. But that made your father proud, didn't it?
Yes, sir. He took Sam down to the paper and got his picture took. It was on the front page, great big.
Front page? Great big? That's like your father has his picture on the front page sometimes, isn't it?
Yes, sir. My papa's an important man.
Oh, you got that right, Oscar. Father sure is. Very important man. You know, I bet it must be hard to get noticed sometimes in a family like that, with your father away in Washington and Congress and campaigning, you know, and hunting when he has time. And your big brother doing big things this year. It must be hard to get much attention in a family like that, huh? Especially since you're the smallest and you're pretty quiet yourself, huh? Do you like to hunt, Oscar? No? I mean, a boy like yourself living out in the country with all those birds and squirrels? What?
I don't want to shoot anything. Not since Danny died.
Right. Oscar, do you know exactly where Mr. Shipley's watermelon patch is?
Sure. I've been there a lot. I even took Danny there once.
In fact, the watermelon patch is close to the house, not by the woods, huh? As a matter of fact, the only thing that's by the woods is that gun, right? You wanted that gun, didn't you, Oscar? Well, why? Why would a boy who doesn't like to shoot anything want with a rusty old shotgun? Huh? Are you being signaled by your father? Did he coach you in the house before you got here?
I object, Your Honor. Counsel's speculating, and the child's already said he doesn't remember anything after he climbed the fence, which, of course, was when he was shot.
No more questions, Your Honor. Thanks.
Very well. Oscar, you're through, son. You don't have to come back.
It's my boy. Ruthie. Good day.
I can be invisible.
You can? Well, not too many people can be invisible. Did you learn that so you could hunt those wild turkeys, too?
Girls don't hunt, but they can be invisible.
Well, it's good to see you, Ruthie. You take good care of Oscar, too.
He's tough. He said in the hospital. But he doesn't want to be invisible. He wants Papa to see him.
Well, you have a nice day. I guess I'm gonna have to take down all these frills and laces, huh?
Well, when we come to visit, Paul will just have to get used to it.
Good, good. I'd like to sit in here from time to time. Whenever I want to think about my little baby girl. Hmm. Well, we had some pretty good talks in here, haven't we?
Braces.
Ah.
Boys.
Right.
High heel shoes.
Boys.
Boys. Sophomore algebra.
Boys.
Boys. Danny. Mama.
You know, when I was coming out of the courthouse today, I ran into little Ruthie Henley, and I couldn't get over the feeling that she was trying to tell me something. Couldn't figure out what it was. Felt awful stupid. Of course, I felt that way before, haven't I?
Like when I was a teenager?
Oh, right.
You were stupid, Daddy. But you've gotten so much smarter since then.
Really?
Yeah.
Not so sure.
Did you warn the Henley children about the gun?
Sure I did.
And that's because they got into your garden from time to time. Is that right?
They'd cut across to come play with my kids. To steal a watermelon, of course. All boys do that. Little Oscar there, he used to get into the garden a lot.
He did?
Yes, sir.
And yet, you still put a gun in your garden and rigged it to shoot anything that moved.
I only loaded it for when the deer were feeding of an evening, and then unloaded it in the morning on account of the kids being around.
Please, Mr. Shipley, just answer the question. Did you or did you not rig a gun in your garden? Well?
Yes, sir. I guess I could.
But this gun just happened not to be loaded the night it shot Oscar Henley.
No, I think there was a couple of nights that I didn't.
Speak up, Mr. Shipley, please. The jury can't hear you.
Yes, sir. No, sir. I mean, I don't think it was.
No. Of course not.
How'd it go today?
Well, Rance is not a very good witness, or Lansdowne's a very good lawyer, or both.
You'll be all right.
Ruthie, you like cherry pie. Try that.
It's not very good, is it?
I'm sorry about that. Maybe if you take a big gulp of iced tea, you might be able to wash the taste down. Ruthie, you know that thing you tried to tell me the other day? Could it possibly... You knew that Horace had a drinking problem.
Well, let's just say that I'm not surprised.
Well, if you're not surprised, why are you objecting?
Legally, I have to say I'm surprised. Personally, I'm not.
Am I the only man in the county who didn't know?
Probably, Daniel.
I thought I knew everything there was to know about Horace Henley.
Well, you don't exactly travel in the same social circles. What did you think that attack at the hospital was that first day? The vapors? Whatever you knew about Horace, it's only as much as Horace needed you to know.
Reverend Roberts and his bunch will have a field day with this one. I guess I'll be sorry to see old Horace disappear from the political scene. But not very. I'll let you call her to the stand. But if she doesn't want to talk, she's gone. I can't allow a fishing expedition or an abuse of discretion, even for the defense.
What do you mean he's calling Ruthie for the defense? My daughter, Ruthie?
Yeah. I don't see how it's going to be a problem. Unless she knows something.
Well, what's to know? Nothing.
Well, then there's no problem, is there?
No. No problem at all.
Hi, Ruthie. Do you mind telling us what happened when Oscar got shot? Ruthie.
You love your mother and father, don't you? Yeah. But, there's a secret in your house, isn't it? Well, I already know the secret. Mm-hmm. And so does Mr. Lansdowne. And so does the judge. And so does a whole lot of other people. So it's all right. You can tell us what happened the night that Oscar got shot. Go ahead.
I woke up because I could hear Papa downstairs yelling at Oscar, and Oscar was crying. That's one of the ways you can tell the secret's there, because Papa yells in the middle of the night. That, and there's a bottle hidden. It's not all the time, just sometimes.
And what did your Papa say to Oscar?
He said that he was a coward. He said that he was gonna make him shoot a gun. Oscar said he didn't want to on account of what happened to Danny. Papa said he didn't care about that.
Oscar! Oscar, I hear you! Get in here, Oscar! Hey. Look at that, you see the picture of your brother? One in a turkey shoot. What kind of son are you? Afraid of guns? Huh?
But Danny, he...
I don't want to hear that, Danny! Get out of my sight! You make me sick, you little yellow belly.
Then what happened?
And Oscar ran to his room and cried for a while. And then I guess he made up his mind to go.
Go?
To Mr. Shibley's garden. There was a gun there. Then Papa couldn't call him a coward.
I see. So that's how Oscar got shot.
No, sir. He brought the gun home okay. It had a couple wires on it and a string, and it was heavy. But he brought it home okay.
Oh, when and how did Oscar get shot?
He took the gun into the living room where Papa was on his chair. He woke Papa up and showed it to him.
Get that thing. Let me see. Did you get this? You little yellow belly is not loaded.
And Papa took the gun and looked at it and said that Oscar was still a coward.
I'm sorry, Lizzie. Could you please repeat that louder so that the judge and the jury and everyone can hear?
Papa said that any coward could carry a gun that wasn't loaded.
So, the gun was not loaded when Oscar took it from Mr. Shipley's garden, right?
No, sir. And Papa said that a hunter, a real hunter, had to know how to handle a gun that was loaded. So he took out his own shotgun shells and put two in the gun. And then told Oscar to put it back where he found it to prove that he could handle a gun that was loaded. It went off when Oscar went to put it back.
Yeah, try to be a man.
After Papa loaded it. But it wasn't Papa's fault. Oscar, he put it back up on the post. And Mr. Shipley, he's nice, but he came out of the dark and scared Oscar. And Oscar climbed the fence, and that's when the gun went off. It was just an accident.
Your Honor, the state moves to strike all of this incredible testimony, which clearly can only be regarded as hearsay.
How did you know this, Ruthie? Did Oscar tell you?
No, sir. I was there.
But no one mentioned seeing you there, honey. Not Oscar nor Mr. Shipley.
Nobody saw me. I was invisible. I taught myself so I could get around the house and Papa's like that. I can open a door so he won't hear it. I can turn on the light in the bathroom so he can't hear the switch. I can climb the stairs so they won't squeak. Nobody knows I'm there at all. I couldn't let Mr. Shipley get in trouble. I couldn't tell just for him. I had to tell for Oscar. But he's brave. He had to go get that big old gun alone at night, scared to death. He's little and he's quiet, but he's brave, Papa. And he just wants you to be proud of him too.
What do you think the jury will do?
I gave up predicting juries a long time ago.
She's a good little girl, isn't she?
Yes, she is. Very good girl. Very brave, with a great heart. Just like a mama.
I just wish I'd been as strong as she is.
Well, you had no choice, Aurora. Horace took care of that.
That Aurora, she's a crazy woman. Should have left her alone from the start. But I talked to Mary. She says she'll sign the papers.
Mary agreed to this?
Mrs. Henley wants to be a congressman's wife. She saw right away we couldn't take a chance on this woman showing up in town with a baby on her hip. So Mary and I are going to adopt the baby, just like we were being generous or something. Mary's going to tell everybody it came from this little high school girl that her family knows up in Steelville, but I need those papers today before she changes her mind.
You mean the baby's born?
Yeah, yesterday. Well, it's out of state. No records here.
Well, what if Faroe decides to change her mind later?
Look, I know it's a rotten situation, but it's a perfect solution. Now, you get this paperwork done today, and I'll make sure you get that state contracting work I promised. Okay?
All right.
You know, that way, you'll be able to buy that big old house with the rose garden that Olivia had been wanting. Okay?
What's gonna happen to Ruthie now?
Well, I don't know about Horace, but, Mary. She's very kind and a very good mother. And she loves Ruthie.
I wish I could tell Ruthie. But I don't want to shame her. And I am so ashamed.
Now, some secrets are better kept forever, Aurora. Alice? You sure the windows are open in here? It's suffocating.
Don't you want to make a good impression at your daughter's wedding? And what if the jury comes in and you have to go down to the courthouse?
Well, why did we let her plan a wedding in the middle of the day, in the middle of the summer, in the middle of the Ozarks? We find some equatorial place to go, like the Calcutta or Guam, and we have some African relatives. Stop!
Just try to think cool thoughts.
Right, cool thoughts. My wrist. Oh, my goodness. Baby girl, what's the matter?
I came to tell you. Mama says she's sick. She can't come down.
Olivia, come downstairs.
You know, I still think of ways to kill Barney Watling. I was so disappointed when he killed himself. He cheated me, Daniel. He cheated me.
Well, if you don't say that, at least not today. Today's Camille's day.
Camille understands I can never be happy again. Ever. I killed my baby.
Oh, no, Olivia, I'm responsible for that. And I can accept that. I deserve it. But Olivia, Camille is our child, too. She adores you.
And I adore her.
She's innocent. Olivia, if there's any hope, any love left in you, you come downstairs. This is the only and last thing I'll ever ask you to do, Olivia. Please. Olivia, come down for Camille. She needs you.
You see that sundial they have, Lois? Grow old along with me, the best is yet to be. Nice touch. We ought to get one for the kids.
Where's Olivia? We can't start the wedding without Olivia.
Well, she's really not feeling that well. She might come
back.
Oh,
my.
Please forgive me. It's taken me longer than I realized to get ready.
Praise be.
Thank you.
can't, Daniel. I can't.
Sheriff said the jury has gone home for the night. They were all smiling when they left. None of this would have happened except for you, Daniel. And tomorrow, I'm ruined. It's your fault.
You know, Horace, you had the perfect campaign slogan. Make government responsible. That's just another way of blaming somebody else. You blame Aurora. You blame me. But, Horace, if you don't take responsibility for yourself, things will never get better. Things will never change. Ever. So what about Lance? What did he ever do to you?
It was my career. Everything I ever worked for. Couldn't lose all that because of one stupid mistake.
Then you won't get what you deserve.
Huh? Daniel, I didn't know you were going to be out there. And your boy, I never thought. I just wanted Aurora. Look, you weren't supposed to be out there. You got to know that. You weren't supposed to.
I know that. I know that.
Oh, how'd you get like this, Daniel? How'd I get like this? We're so far from where we started. So far from where I meant to be.
You just lost your way, Horace. It's easy to do, you know. Very easy.
Well, what am I going to do now? Where am I going to go? Mary won't have me anymore. She's gone. She took the kids. All of a sudden, Daniel, I'm alone.
This long road you and I have taken, Horace. Only end up in the same place.
Now.
And that's enough punishment for both of us.
Thank you.
Not guilty. It's 9:30. Still time for all of us to get to church. This court is now adjourned.
Good morning.
in. What's wrong? Why are you here so early?
Well, if you'd have heard what I heard in church yesterday, you'd have been here early, too. And I wasn't wrong.
Did something happen?
Something happened, all right. Well, don't you see? You broke through this curse you put on yourself. You're your old self again.
But I thought...
Look, people like to hear the truth. About other people, I mean. And the only way Horace is going back to Congress now is as a whiskey salesman. And you're back in business. You're your own man, not Horace Henley's flunky anymore. Well, it's the truth. It's gonna be like it should have been all along.
Well, things can't be exactly the same way they were, Evelyn.
No, they can't, but they can still be good. Just different.
It can't be that.
I'm gonna stay all day. I told Elmo not to take any more jobs. He can take care of the kids. Oh, and I forgot, Rance is in your office. They were waiting outside when I got here.
Rance. Hey. Don't you have some farm work to catch up on?
No. No, this is more important right now. We all wanted you to have this. As Maddie's.
Oh, no, no, I can't take this.
No, it's all we have to give to you, and it's nothing to what you give us, Mrs. Stewart. We'd be honored if you keep this.
Lord, have mercy. Aurora, how did you get in here? You've got to get out right now.
No, Alice. He came to my rescue and to Rance's and a lot of other people's over the years. It's time someone came to his. I begged him not to wait for you. It was 5 o'clock, and I couldn't wait anymore. But when we got there, and I saw the door was open,
I meant to kill you, Aurora. Not him. It ain't my fault. I warned Horace. I told him if you come out here, I'd shoot the first thing that moved. Told him that when I borrowed the gun. I'm so blind mad.
Barney had never owned a gun in his life. His hobby was drinking, not hunting. He'd never had a gun if Horace hadn't given him one. So he could get rid of me.
I told you what would happen if you came here. Now look at her.
It's all right.
Thank you. Thank you.
The point is, Daniel, Horace never would have been elected without the votes you got him. And there's going to be an opening in the legislature this fall. Someone of your color has to be first. You might have needed Horace once, but you don't need him anymore. I would be proud to support you, Daniel. I've run a successful campaign or two myself. You'd have a chance. What do you say?
It's Alice. Something's happened to Olivia.
Excuse me. Alice, what is it?
You better get in there.
Lily? What is it?
Daniel, Aurora came here.
Oh, I'm sorry. I told her not to come here, not to talk to you.
Oh, no. No, Daniel. I'm so glad she did. I remember every second of that day.
Danny? Daniel? Daniel?
Hi, Horace, it's Livy. Listen, is Danny still there with Oscar? Oh, good. Daniel did get him then. Good, good. No, I just wanted to check because nobody's home. Well, I'm sure Daniel took him along. Oh, he loves to go with his daddy. Horace? What's wrong? Are you all right? Dangerous. But why didn't you tell me what Horace did?
Well, Daniel was already dead. What difference would it have made?
Oh, Daniel. It would have made all the difference in the world. Because I blamed you. But it was Horace.
I'm not proud of what I did. When Barney killed himself, the only people that knew was me and Aurora and Horace. So, I had a choice to make. I knew if the people in the town found out that Horace had given that shotgun to Barney, he'd be ruined. I knew if you found out what Horace had done, you'd never let him get away with it. And I needed to let Horace get away with it. I didn't want Danny to die for nothing. So I kept Horace's filthy little secrets.
To make him put electricity in Silver Shade?
Yeah.
Danny would have been so proud. Out of all this darkness, his daddy brought the light.
I was late that day. Because I was trying on hats. I wanted to punish you for being gone all the time. And always having to wait for you. I even said to the sales lady, I said, a few more minutes wouldn't kill anybody. It was so much easier to be mad than to about what I had done. And I couldn't face you, Daniel. I just kept thinking, what would I do the day somebody told you they saw me trying on hats? I guess it really isn't anybody's fault, is it, Daniel? Just all these little things that came together in such a terrible way. Daniel, do you think you could still grow old along with me?
I don't think it'd be the same, Olivia.
But I do love you, Daniel. I do so want to try.